Only a handful of albums transcend your time, leaving a lasting mark on both the genre and popular culture. But even fewer albums have successfully captured that feeling of a lifestyle and experience so strong, it feels like the listeners are living in it. In this video, we're diving into one of the most iconic albums of the last decade, Good Kid MAAD City by Kendrick Lamar. The title on the album cover of Good Kid MAAD City reads, a short film by Kendrick Lamar, and that is exactly what the album feels like. It's a literal day in the life of Kendrick, a good kid, trying to survive in a MAAD city. The album is in many ways a coming-of-age story of a kid who struggles to maintain his innocence in an environment that is very far from innocent. He's surrounded by sex, drugs, violence, and overall delinquency. But he understands at a young age that there is a way out, a better way. However, escaping a fate of demise would prove to be difficult. The album cover is a Polaroid of baby Kendrick with his two teenage uncles and granddad. Everyone's eyes are blanked out except for his, and he stares right into the lens, playing into the theme of an innocent kid in a crazy environment. If you look closer, there's a lot hidden in plain sight. A baby bottle is right beside a bottle of alcohol, a topic Kendrick addresses on the album. There's a photo of Kendrick and his dad on the wall, and one uncle whose lap baby Kendrick is sitting on is flashing a gang sign. A few years after this photo was taken, Kendrick, aged just 5, would witness his first murder, a teenage drug dealer gunned down in front of his childhood home. This was a foreshadowing of the genesis of the story that has continued to unfold 4 albums down the line. Kendrick was a modern-day version of a backpack rapper, and with Section 80, he was able to combine expressing the realities of this gangster life with a consciousness to reflect on the dangers of this lifestyle. But something is different on Good Kid MAAD City. The album is divided into 2 halves. The first half details a single day in Kendrick's life, while the second explores the aftermath of that day. Each track is like a scene in the movie, with Kendrick as the protagonist, transporting listeners into the gritty streets of Compton, his turbulent family dynamics, and his constant struggle between temptation and redemption. The album isn't exactly chronological, and the opening track, Shireen, aka Master Splinter's daughter, isn't really the beginning of the story. But it introduces one of the album's main themes, temptation. Shireen is a girl from Kendrick's neighborhood who Kendrick is infatuated with, but his desires are soon overshadowed by the fear that she might have ulterior motives and connections to a rival gang. Kendrick then faces the choice between following his desires and staying true to his conscience, a dilemma that repeats itself throughout the album. The song is immediately followed by a voicemail skit, and these were essential in tying the plot of the album together, bringing us into his world and giving it the feel of a movie.
Kendrick, where you at? Damn, I'm sitting here waiting on my van. You told me you was gonna be back in 15 minutes.
Over the next few songs and skits, the album's narrative becomes clearer, and the real story actually begins in the 4th song, The Art of Peer Pressure. On this song, we're introduced to Kendrick's friends and another central theme of the album, peer pressure. Throughout the track, we see Kendrick engage in activities that he wouldn't normally participate in, giving into the pressures and expectations of his friends.
Am I built for this? Is this what I'm supposed to be doing? Am I good enough?
The next track, Money Trees, ties right into this theme of peer pressure, but also tackles other aspects of Kendrick's life at the time. Kendrick grew up without a silver spoon, so he felt he needed to hustle to earn money. Alongside pressure from his homies, he had the desire to make money in whatever way possible, even if it was illegal. On the hook, he says, "Money trees is the perfect place for shade," which plays on the popular saying, "Money doesn't grow on trees."
Money trees is the perfect place for shade, and that's just how I feel.
Kendrick counters that saying by suggesting that money will allow him to live out his desires. In everything he does or thinks about doing, he makes sure to tell his friends about it for validation. From home invasions, to unprotected sex, to even robbing an innocent reverend, even as music was his escape in the midst of his vices, he prioritized this lifestyle, which he vividly reflects on this song.
I was getting a point of view that my homeboys wasn't getting. All they seen was my pop's point of view, you know, and their uncle's point of view and the big homie point of view. They didn't have that mama. But at the same time, I had that balance because I had a mom, had both parents in the house, and she gave me the side of being a dreamer and telling me I can do whatever I want to do.
Every second, every minute, man, I swear that she can get it. Say if you a bad bitch, put your hands up high.
Poetic Justice takes us right back to the beginning with Shireen. Kendrick runs into a group of men outside Shireen's house who jump him. This is a wake-up call for Kendrick, as he realizes that the tables could turn just as easily, making him a target in this mad city instead. And as the album progresses into the second half, Kendrick comes to the realization that unless he finds his way out, that will be his fate as well. A major turning point in the narrative comes in the ninth track of the album, where one of Kendrick's homies dies from a shootout after his friends seek revenge against the people who jumped Kendrick earlier, and we learn his name was Dave.
Dave! These bitches niggas killed my brothers!
The next track, which is also the longest song on the album, Sing About Me, is inspired by this loss. On this track, Kendrick encapsulates all his fears, insecurities, hopes, desires, and regrets with poetic storytelling. Reality sets in that the lifestyle that he wanted to be a part of leads to almost nothing good. Death and dysfunction were almost inevitable if he led the life he once desired to. Ultimately, Kendrick gains the wisdom needed in order to survive the environment he was thrown into. On Real, he reflects on his mentality and questions what he sees as real. He realizes that his definition of being real had just been him living for others and not himself. This makes him question why he had this mindset and comes to the realization that it is from a lack of self-love. The world cornered Kendrick into this reality, and his coping mechanism was doing what others thought he was supposed to do. He finds that the only way to be real is by being a good person, taking care of his family, and standing by his beliefs, not that of others.
Real is responsibility. Real is taking care of your motherfucking family. Real is God, nigga.
Real becomes his realization of self. The album's climax, Compton, finds Kendrick Lamar reconciling with the duality of his city, acknowledging its flaws while celebrating its resilience. Kendrick Lamar has undeniably solidified his position as one of the most esteemed hip-hop artists in history, and it's albums like Good Kid MAAD City that have earned him such high acclaim. This particular album stands as a true masterpiece, skillfully weaving a captivating narrative that transports the listener into the vivid experiences of a young man hailing from Compton. And its impact was so profound that it is widely considered the most iconic album of 2012.